the beaten Hawthorn at the MCG. Peter McKinnon was here yesterday. Peter, the thing that really struck me, there was so much emotion, so much physical effort put into yesterday's game, and the bottom line was that it counted for nothing in the end because they've got to do it again next Sunday.
Well, it was a shame that the winner of that game didn't get the double chance because the effort put in by both sides was absolutely fantastic. And what came out of the game, of course, is that Melbourne is a far better side than people give them credit for. And in fact, early in the first couple of minutes, Hawthorn kicked the first two goals, and I thought, how far, Hawthorn? They're going to steamroll Melbourne. Peter Rode lined up on Dermot Brereton at centre back, Tony Campbell on Dunstall, and I thought, well, this is going to be an absolute hiding. But Melbourne were fantastic. Their tackling was superb. They chased. They're very, very quick. They were well coached yesterday. They had an extra man in defence and many, many times to bottle up that Hawthorn forward line. And the little fella Jackson was snooping around. Bennett was creating all sorts of problems down there for Langford. He's the only full forward in the league that really troubles Chris Langford continually. And Langford looked worried all day.
Do you think this habit of playing one less forward on the forward line will become the norm in the future?
Well, it could certainly work against you at times too. It means you've got one less player somewhere else. But I think it worked well against Hawthorn because Hawthorn relies so much on that breakaway and getting to the open spaces with Dunstall running to that space. And yesterday it just created problems for the Hawks, and Dermot was down at centre-half forward. That also created problems. But I think Northey is a very, very shrewd coach, and they were well coached yesterday.
Tony Hall, in the highlights there, I saw him a couple of times. Is he close to being a good player again?
Well, I reckon he's one of the best players in the competition. He played superbly yesterday on the wing. He took about 11 marks. He would have had 16 kicks, and he's not 100% fit, but he's running into form, and he is a superb overhead mark.
Peter, Ayres being injured is a body blow to Hawthorn, isn't it?
Big loss. And, well, two of their great finals campaigners will be out, Dipier Domenico and Ayres, and they'll be sorely missed. But this was a magnificent game of football yesterday.
Peter, you know, we all know about the psychological build-up, and there was a great incentive for both sides yesterday if the West Coast had have dropped that game down at Geelong. Which team can come up best next week?
Well, I've said before here on at Sports World, I don't tip against Hawthorn too often, and I think that Hawthorn will come up and beat Melbourne next week. But Melbourne has played; they play well at the MCG, and they're young and they can run, and they surprised me yesterday. They're much better than I thought.
The ground was pockmarked, Peter. Is it all right, Dave?
Well, the ground wasn't too bad. It's a little bit shifty, Bob, but both sides have to play on it. As far as the votes go, I went one vote for Gary Lyon. The only reason he didn't get the three votes, his opponent, Ray Jenke, had a lot of kicks on him, 20-odd kicks. Darren Bennett was superb. Could have kicked 10, gave away a couple, chased hard. And Brett Lovett, well, when it was, he was tough and hard in that halfback flank, and he is a very highly skilled player as well. A good, great game by Brett Lovett.
Thanks for that, Peter.
Likewise here, Sir Andrew Collins has a perfect sit. A pretty mark, that.
And I'm rapt to see this fella back in the Melbourne side, Newport. Had a pretty ordinary mid-season, but it was a good effort.
Look at that. One-handed pick-up, then steadied, straightened up. Beautiful balance. He is a